Hi, DJ Spiess here. In this tutorial, we're going to add an event to your calendar in iOS 9 using Swift 2.0. Apple's changed quite a bit in iOS 9 and Swift 2, so the code in this video will not work for previous versions. The constants in EventKit are a bit different as well. The source code for this tutorial is on GitHub. Here's the link. It's also in the comments and on dgu.com. So, let's get started.
The basic workflow for performing any EventKit action is to first get an instance of the event store. Then check to see if you have permission to mess with the calendar. If you don't, ask. Once you have permission, you can either create or read or and delete an event. So first, let's create an event store. We can do that simply with a constructor. The event store is a context, so if you create an event object with one event store, you can't use it with another event store somewhere else in your application. If you're passing around events and reminders, you'll probably want to create the event store as a singleton in your application. Next, we want to make sure we have permission to use the calendar. If we don't check, our users might accidentally deny permission, and then we'll be left wondering why nothing works. We check for access by calling authorization status for entity type on the event store. We'll pass the entity type as event. If the user's already given our application access, our code in the else block will run. If our app doesn't have permission, we'll ask for it. When we ask, we pass the entity type and a code block of what to do if we get permission. If the user denies our application, the block just won't be executed. Assuming we do get permission, we can perform actions on the event store. To create a calendar event programmatically, we simply use the constructor passing it to the event store. That's why we might consider creating a singleton for the event store. If we try to create an event with one event store and then try saving that event in a different store, it won't work. We could save it with one store and then read it into a new event object with a different store. The gotcha is the event instance you create is tied to the specific store. Once the event's created, we can populate the fields. We'll set the title. That's what gets displayed in the calendar. We'll specify the current time for the start date and an end time. We can specify the calendar to add to the event, but we'll just use the default to keep this simple. Then, when we try to save it, we can specify a span for the event. Basically, the span tells the event store we either mean this event and all others after it. We're working with just one event, so we use the constant this event. If we're successful, we can verify the event in the calendar. Now, assume we want to delete the calendar event programmatically. We need the event identifier to load the event to delete. We'll read it, and if it's not nil, we'll ask the event store to remove the event. That's it. I've created a simple program highlighting this code. I've created two buttons on a single view. The first button schedules an event into your calendar, the other removes the event. The code's pretty simple, and it's just to highlight how to perform the actions. Since I'm saving the event identifier after creating it, if you create a second event, there'll be no way to delete the first. This is just to give you an idea how to do it. In the add event and remove event methods, we verify we have permission to use the event store. These are the IB actions for the buttons. If we have permission, we call create event or delete event. These simply perform the action in the event store.
And that's how you programmatically add an event to your calendar using iOS 9 and Swift 2.0. If you like this video, make sure you like and share. This helps get the tutorial in front of other viewers. New lessons come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. You don't want to miss a tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.